Okay, so last class we discussed this relation. Okay, so for entropy, we know that dq is equal to TdS. This is for a reversible process, right? And then we applied first law also. We used dq is equal to du plus pdv. This is coming from the first law. And here we are basically using both the results from first law and second law. And then what we did was we wrote dh in the form of CpdT. And basically we formed different equations for ds using Cp, Cv, and R. So these are the two equations that we derived in the last class. I hope everyone is okay with that. And moving on. So let us now talk for a perfect gas. So for a perfect gas, we can write entropy relation like this. And if you basically, if I want to calculate entropy for any point, any state, let us say it is 2 or any other other than 2, I can use it for a general term. So I can write S and I will drop that subscript 2. So these are some equations. Now we know that R is a function of temperature, and it is a difference between Cp minus Cv. Generally we take R to be 1.4 for air. So from kinetic theory of gases, we will not go into the detail of this derivation, but what we can see is that gamma is the ratio of Cp and Cv. This is equal to n plus 2 by n. Now this n is basically the degrees of freedom. So it will be different if you have a, let's say, monoatomic molecule, monoatomic gas, or if you have a polyatomic molecule, if you have a large compressed molecule, n will be more. So for a monoatomic gas, n is equal to 3 and gamma you get 1.67. And if you have a large complex molecule, then n will be very large. So this gamma will be approaching 1 unity. Okay, so if n is very large, 2 is not very significant in compared to n. So n by n almost equals to 1. So overall we can say that n gamma varies from 1 to 1.67. Okay. Now for any adiabatic process, we know that h plus v square by 2 is constant. So from where this is coming, can anyone tell me? Which equation or what is conserved here?
Energy.
Yes. So this is coming from the basically steady flow energy equation. So it says that enthalpy and kinetic energy is conserved. So I am assuming that potential energy is not changing for this process. Now we use this to define stagnation enthalpy. This is called H dot that we have defined in the previous lecture. So this is the enthalpy for a stagnant liquid, a stagnant fluid, stagnant gas. Basically, let's say that your fluid is inside a reservoir. So inside the reservoir, there's no velocity, is assumed to be zero. So the total enthalpy plus kinetic energy converts to stagnation enthalpy. This is H dot, which is constant for a flow for any adiabatic process. So H we can also write as Cpt. So Cpt plus this v square is equal to Cpt naught for stagnation enthalpy, and this is your stagnation temperature. Okay, and this is true for perfect gas, where Cp by Cv is gamma. And now we'll try to manipulate this equation. So because Cp by Cv is gamma, I can also write Cp by gamma is Cv and R is Cp minus Cv. So I can write R as 1 minus 1 by gamma into Cp using these two relations. Okay, or I can write Cp in terms of gamma and R, just taking this bracket on the left hand side. Okay, or I can write Cpt as this. So here we have CPT which I wanted to convert to other form. So I can write that CPT in terms of gamma, R and T, gamma and R basically. So I can, this is what we have in the last slide. Now this is the equation that we need to substitute. So if I substitute the value of CPT, instead of CPT, I write gamma by gamma minus 1 into RT. So what I will get? And also I have PV is equal to RT. So P by rho becomes RT. Or in other words, I can write, instead of RT, I can write P by rho. So CPT becomes gamma, this is the same bracket, gamma by gamma minus 1, into RT, instead of RT, I write P by rho. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if I use this in the energy equation, instead of CPT, I write gamma minus 1 into P by rho. This becomes, this is basically called compressible Bernoulli equation for isentropic flows. So this is one form of Bernoulli equation. We'll see one more form is there. So this can be used for any isentropic flow, compressible isentropic flow. Okay, generally for incompressible flow, we take rho as constant, but here rho can also vary. So that is the advantage of this compressible Bernoulli equation. Again, as we have discussed that CPT plus V square, this is basically your stagnation enthalpy, and which is constant. And here you also see that if we have different conditions, for all the conditions, the stagnation conditions will be same if it is an isentropic or adiabatic flow. So we can say that the stagnation temperature will remain constant. So any subscript, let us say 1, 2, whatever you have, if you add CPT plus V square by 2, it will give you basically stagnation enthalpy at that point. So that stagnation temperature will be same for all the points in the flow. That is what this is about. Okay. Now let us talk about entropy. So entropy can be written like this. S2 is enthalpy of entropy at state 2, which is written in terms of entropy at state 1 plus pressure and density terms. Now we know that if you take this equation and if you take the ratio of P2 by P1 and take instead of log, if you take exponential, so you will end up with this. Okay. Is this clear how we have gone into this equation? Okay, so let me write it more clearly. So basically we have S2 minus N1 plus this log term is there. Okay, now if you take Cp by Cv is anyway gamma, right? So if you take the this power log, okay, any number multiplied by any variable into log of this, I can write log of this to the power that, right? Is this okay?
Yes, sir.
So what I can do is I can take Cv common from here. This will be gone. I will let's see, that is the problem. If you don't have blackboard, I want to. So let us say I shift S from here to here. Okay. Now I want to divide this by Cv. So what I can do is, this was very easy if I have a blackboard, but it is not there, so it is energy is whatever we have. So I want to divide it by CV, right? So this becomes log of P minus, now it, I will divide it over all. Okay. Okay, you see this? So S1 has gone to the LHS, S2 minus S1 divided by CV. CV has gone to the LHS. So it will get divided, right? So if I take common CV from here to here, what I will get? This CV will be gone. Now for this, this will become CP by CV. Okay, what is, can I write gamma here instead of this? Instead of CP by CV, can I write gamma?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me put gamma here. Okay. Now we have LHS is this quantity. If I take exponential on both the sides, or let us say this is log. So I can write instead of log A minus log B, I can write log of A by B or to the power of this. So let me put a bigger bracket. Okay, or look at it, I'll explain while writing. So up to this is clear to you, right? We are just shifting, taking CV common and shifting S1 to LHS. Is it all right? Now instead of this quantity, I can write gamma. Okay. Now gamma can go on top of this. I can write gamma like this. Log of this to the power gamma. Okay. Now we have log A minus log B. And this side we have this quantity. So if I take exponential, it becomes exponential to the power this, which is written here. Okay. And
okay.
If I take exponential, log becomes this. Exponential will remove the log sign. So we'll have P2 minus P1. And this can go, if minus log, if it goes that side, it becomes plus log. So we'll have this quantity plus this is equal to this. Okay. So if I take exponential, it becomes log will sign will go. So it becomes P2 by P1 is equal to rho 2 by rho 1 to the power gamma. So this will go to this, that side into exponential of this. Is it clear now?
Okay.
Okay. Moving on. So see, in this subject, there are a lot of derivations. So I better get used to it. And anyway, I will strongly suggest that once after the class, you just, I will upload these slides. So just download the slides and try to derive it on your own. So you will get more confident and you will be clear what steps and what assumptions are involved. Okay. Okay. Now we have this equation for entropy in terms of CP, temperature and pressure. Now for an isentropic flow, this term will be zero, LHS will be zero. There is no change in entropy when you're talking about isentropic. So I can write this RHS equal to zero. Or I can also write log of this is equal to log of pressure is equal to CP, LHS is equal to CP by R into log of this. Or in other words, if I remove the log sign, similarly, I will take this quantity to the power of T. So I'll say P2 by P1 is equal to T2 by T1 to the power CP by R. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, in previous slides, what we have seen is CP is equal to gamma to the power gamma minus 1 into R. If I substitute this CP like this, I can change this equation to this form. So basically, I'm removing Cp by R, and instead of that, I'm putting gamma by gamma minus 1, which is here. Okay, so this is one important relation for isentropic flow. Generally, we say PV to the power gamma is constant, or P by T to the power gamma by gamma minus 1 is constant. Okay, similarly, we'll derive another equation. So for this equation, again, we similarly substitute delta S is 0 for isentropic. And here we have log of V2 by V1. In previous slides, we talked about pressure. Similarly, we'll derive an equation for volume, specific volume. So similarly, V2 by V1 is equal to minus T2 by T1 to the power minus Cv by R. Okay, this is the quantity. So similarly, I'll put Cv by R is equal to 1 by gamma minus 1, and we get a relation terms of specific volume and temperature. So these are the basic equations for isentropic flow. These are isentropic relations. Okay. So last night, for example, we got pressure and temperature. This time we got volume, specific volume and temperature. Okay, now this is what we got in the last slide. And we also know that rho is basically density, is inverse of specific volume. So using these two, I can write the ratio of rho 2 by rho 1 is equal to basically T2 by T1. Okay, now this minus 1 is removed because it will be reverse. Okay, basically this will be, this is equal to rho 1 by rho 2, because rho and volume has, specific volume has inverse relation. So because this is V2 by V1, I have to write rho 1 by rho 2. But this is, there is a minus in the power. So if I remove that and inverse it, so I'll have rho 2 by rho 1 is equal to T2 by T1 to the power 1 minus gamma minus 1. Okay. And again, this is what we have derived, exponential term. So I can also write P, basically P into rho, P by rho to the power gamma is constant, or P2 by P1 is equal to rho 2 by rho 1 to the power gamma for isentropic flow. So understand how we got this from this. Can anyone tell me?
S2 minus S1 put it
yes.
Zero.
So if this is 0, this term will go, this term will become 1. Exponential of 0 is 1. So we are left with this term, that's all. Right? So this is called a Poisson's equation. Okay, so these are the equations that we have derived in previous slides. So we talked, basically we are talking in terms of temperature, pressure, specific volume and density. These are the four terms that are involved, and we are using gamma as a power for different ratios. So if I combine the last three, I can write this equation in terms of pressure, density and temperature. Okay, so these are some of the important relations that we will use for deriving flow equations for 1D and 2D flow. So these are the basically building blocks of compressible flow. So be very clear with how this equation was derived, what are the assumptions involved, and what are, for example, we are assuming perfect gas. Okay, so what is the calorific perfect gas, thermally perfect gas, that should be clear to everyone. Moving on. So this is also what we have seen. Basically, we are defining the stagnation enthalpy, Cp T0, which will be constant. So now in this equation, if I divide everywhere from Cp, so I will get, if I remove Cp, I will have T0, and then I also divide by T. Basically, Cp T we need to divide. So this will become T0 by T. This term will become 1, and V square by 2 divided by Cp T. This is what we'll have. Now, I can write this CPT in terms of gamma and R. Right, gamma R by gamma minus 1 that we have seen in last slides. Now this can be written in terms of A, speed of sound. If you remember, we have derived that speed of sound is root of gamma RT. Okay. A square we have derived is equal to gamma RT, right? You remember that?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this whole term I can write in terms of A square. So if you see here, we have A square, we have V square. So A by V is Mach number. So I can, instead of A square, I can write M square here. Okay, or I can write, sorry, I can write M square. If you take this to aside, I can write V square by A square is equal to M square. So the whole terms becomes 1 plus 2 will be always, 2 will be anyways there. Now this gamma 1 by minus 1 will go on the top. So I'll have gamma minus 1 into by 2 into M square. And this is equal to what? T naught by T. Okay. Is this clear? How we have derived for T naught by T?
Yes, sir.
So now you look, this relation, we have derived any temperature for any point of the flow in terms of T naught. T naught is my stagnation temperature. So basically, moving forward, we'll talk about, let us say that there's a big tank. Okay. Now flow is, let us say you make a small hole or orifice. So flow is leaking from this tank. Now for that flow, I will have some rho naught, T naught, which are called stagnation properties. We'll discuss more about this as we go along. So we'll have some stagnation properties, and T naught is one stagnation properties. Now if I want to find the temperature at any point in this flow, okay, I can just use this relation, and I need to know what is the M or what is the Mach number at that particular conditions. So using Mach number and T naught, I can find what is the temperature for that particular point or particular condition. So this is also a very important equation for isentropic flows, or what we will use in compressible flow. Similarly, we have this is what we have derived previously, relation between pressure, density and temperature. This is what we have in the last slide. Now, similarly, I can also, using these two, I can also write, I can, instead of C, instead of using P2, I can write P0. So this relation becomes equal to this one. I can apply this and write a pressure equation in terms of Mach number. Okay. I can also write similarly density equation in terms of Mach number. So are you guys are able to see what I'm doing here? We had the relation previously. We have derived one relation for T naught by T. Now using this, if I substitute that equation here, I'll get different equations for P and rho. That is what we have here. Okay, is this clear to everyone?
Yes.
I will again advise, after this class, you just go through all these slides. So just be clear. What are the equations that are used and what are the different steps? So you will become confident, or don't get scared by these equations. You will see a lot of this equation in this course. Okay. Now, again, let us start with this equation for entropy. And let us write in terms of stagnation quantities. Okay. P1, P2 could be a general term for pressure. So let us put it for stagnation quantities. Okay, let us say there are two reservoirs. Now we know that R is equal to, R is the difference of Cp and Cv. So if I substitute it here, okay, let me put here, I have Cv. So can I write Cv in terms of Cp minus R? right? And I will also reverse the order. So if I write log of P02 by 01, if I reverse it, it will become log P01 by P02, but this log will become negative. So use that negative and use this, we'll end up with this term.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, yes, no, S O naught minus S1. Rearrange slider, you have written T01 barabar T02 barabar T0 at a stagnation point. Pe. Then why
yes. You are writing? Okay, this one you're talking about. T02. Okay, I got you. I remember what you're talking about. Yeah, what is the question?
Question.
So what is the question now? Okay, you're saying that I cannot write like this.
Yes, sir.
That will come. Let me finish the revision. We'll arrive at that conclusion.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
So you're clear how we are doing. So basically, if I take this equation, I inverse this log and I take a positive. Okay. So if I write minus here, I will write P01 by 02. And this is 01 by 02. So the log is inverse and the sign of that changes from plus to minus. So I get, and I substitute R is equal to Cp minus Cb here, I get S02 minus S01 in this form. Now again, pressure can be written in terms of density and temperature. If I substitute it here, I will get here, up to here, that is the same. In the last term, Cp log rho 01 by rho 02, I will write rho in terms of pressure and temperature. Okay, this is getting substituted here. Fine. Or I can say this S02 minus S01 is equal to R log. I will remove this Cp term. Okay. Cp will get cancelled here. Cp log P01, P02, Cp log P01, P02. So this will get cancelled. Now it will remain T term, temperature term. So I'll have R log this plus Cp log temperature. That is what is shown here. Okay. Is this okay? This derivation is okay? Fine. Similarly, let us take another look at this equation. So now we are coming to your question. So you said that for an adiabatic process, for a perfect gas, stagnation temperatures are same, right? So which means that this will get cancelled. Log of 1 is basically 0. So we are left with S02 minus S01 is equal to R log P01 by P02.
Okay.
Okay. Now, basically, what this equation tells you. So from this equation, I can say that entropy changes when there are loss in pressure. Okay. When the pressure changes from P01 to P02, then only there's a change in entropy. If suppose these two pressures are same, so what will be the entropy here? What is the delta S if pressures are same? Anyone?
Zero.
So if pressure are same, it means that there's no change in entropy. Okay. And another important point is that this entropy is not changing with velocity. If you look at this equation, you have only term of pressure. There's no velocity term here. And because of that, there's nothing like static or stagnation entropy. Okay, so when you talked about a temperature, we said that there's a stagnation temperature, there's a stagnation enthalpy, but we cannot say stagnation entropy because this does not change with velocity. It has no effect of velocity. It is dependent only on pressure. Also, the stagnation temperature does not change even when there are pressure losses. Stagnation temperature will remain same. Okay. And pressure loss is basically a natural way. So that if you look at second law, this is how flow proceeds. So when you want to establish a flow, you will generally we establish a pressure differential, or we give a pressure gradient which causes the pressure. So it is natural for a flow to go from higher pressure to lower pressure for any fluid. So that whatever is natural is bound to increase the entropy. Second law says that all natural processes proceed in a way that entropy increases, right? So whenever there is a pressure loss, then you see a change in increase in entropy by this equation. So pressure loss means if this changes, that will also change. Entropy will account directly from pressure loss. Okay. Another thing is that when there are losses, there will be an increase in entropy leading to drop in stagnation pressure. So this is the converse of this. So whenever there are losses, pressure has to change and a corresponding increase in entropy will be visible. Okay. Now these losses could be due to friction, suppression, shocks, etc. That will see in subsequent lectures. What are these losses? Okay. Now we have assumed air to be perfect gas or whatever gas is there. That was the basis of our discussion in previous slides. We have assumed that it is a perfect gas, but let us have a look how true is that. Okay. So for temperature, for if you are using air as this gas, if it is below 500 Kelvin, so it is perfectly, it is quite okay to consider it as a perfect gas. But if your air temperature is between 500 and 2000, it will be only thermally perfect. Okay, calorically it will not be perfect. So can anyone tell me the difference? What is the difference between calorically and thermally thermally perfect? So if you remember, we discussed that Cp, Cv will be a function of temperature and it will also be constant. So thermally perfect means it will be a function of temperature, but it will not be constant. That is the difference. Just go back and revise those slides. And when you have a temperature which is more than 2000 K, then the gas becomes imperfect, both in terms of thermally and calorically definitions. Okay, so with that, we'll end up with this lecture. And these are some of the reference book that you could refer to. Okay.